Hi, in this video, we are going to talk about how to set up the development environment so that you can do your JavaScript development. And we'll also see how to use the Chrome Developer Tools plus the IDE Visual Studio Code. Actually, you can use any editor, you can use even Notepad, but that's not recommended. It will still work. What I recommend is using the Visual Studio Code like editor, this one. Okay, you can use the Visual Studio Code. This is a beautiful editor. However, I'm not going to describe on how to use this editor. I have made another video on that, and it's here. You can go to this YouTube and watch my video on that. And this is the video. Okay, you can watch this video on YouTube on setting up your code editor. And however, in this video, I want to talk about how to set up your Chrome development environment. Okay. What we actually need is to open the DevTools. So you can go here and you can actually open the DevTools of any. Like you can go here and you can say More Tools and Developer Tools. Or you can just, all that you can do is you can quickly, on the page, you can just say Inspect Element and it will open the Developer Tools. That's another way to do that. So what is Developer Tools? Let me explain a bit of that. Developer Tools actually allows you to see things from the browser's perspective. Okay, and as a developer, you would use these tools to run through. Now, to use a developer tool, we will actually go ahead and open any page. Now, because I always have Google as my homepage, I actually, when I go and open up Inspect Element, it opens up my developer tools. It comes with all these scripts, which is about this Google page. I don't want that. So what you and I, we should do is what we can go ahead and create a file. We'll go ahead and create a file called index.html or any file with an HTML name. And then just, press exclamation on this is only possible on the Visual Studio Code. I don't know about the editors. We can talk that later. Press exclamation and tab. You have the default template ready. So you can just say this is simple HTML and save it. So once it is saved, I have my index.html ready. I can open it in my, in the browser. Now that I have a very simple HTML, if I do an inspect element, I don't have all the noise, all the other tags and other stuff that you would get if you have Google or any other web page on it. So now our idea is to work on the console. So we'll be working more on this console. And say, for example, if I have to declare a variable, I'll say variable A is assigned 10. Okay, so instead of doing programming in the Visual Studio Code and then looking at the results, we can actually go ahead and do it here. So most of our learning will be happening here. So this is how you start. You can also use Firefox, but my recommendation is Chrome, and we'll continue to use Chrome. The other thing that we have to know about is the Sources tab. Okay, in the Sources tab, you can actually have the page, and you can have file system. You can have many other things here, but I want you to take you to the snippets. So go to Sources, go to Snippets, and you can actually have, you can create a new snippet like this. So you can write your JavaScript code here, okay? You can type var is assigned, say 10 here, and then you can say console.log, and say, you just want A to be typed out. So you can just type like this. And once done, you can actually rename it. So you can say test.js or whatever. You don't have to give it a JS name. You're just giving it. And then you can run it. So when you run it, you see that it shows up in this primitives console. So you run it like this, right? I have another code which talks about this code. So if I have to run this code, which I have written, I just go ahead and run it here. And you would see the results out here. Okay. That's about how to use the console, the developer console in Chrome. Okay. Now, let me talk about the data types in JavaScript, and they are the primitive types. We'll look at this in the next video.